Today I'm gonna talk about the relation between power density and the high frequency. Before going to the technical terms of this dilemma, let's have this example. Suppose that we have a classroom. The capacity of this classroom is 6 students. If we have 60 students in total, we can use this classroom 10 times a week, for example. We can say that the number 10 is the frequency for the student to use this classroom. How if we reduce the capacity or the size of the classroom to the half? So the number of students who can use this classroom is 3 at a time instead of 6. By default, the frequency will increase to 20 to cover all 60 students. We reflect this example to many things, and one of the things is the density of power electronics converters. The density of power converter is measured by kilowatt per the cubic meter. Power converters used to utilize passive components to store energy, and the switching devices used to divide energy into small parts and store them inside the capacitors and inductors and recall them when needed. And this process happens very fast. Generally, if we manage to increase the switching frequency of the switching devices to the double, we should be able to reduce the size of passive elements in the power converter to the half. What happens if we keep the same elements without changing the size? The same thing happens in the classroom. If we have a room of 6 student capacity and double the frequency, this means we will use only 3 spaces and will keep other 3 places unused. These unused resources are translated to power losses inside the power converters. Even when you use wires that tolerate, for example, 10 amperes to operate 3 amperes current, the losses increases and consequently the efficiency decreases. In power converters, there is no fixed efficiency. Some converters that have high efficiency at high power could have low efficiency at lower power. Thanks for watching.